Hello and welcome back to my channel. I am sorry that it's been a while. I believe the last video that I put up on the channel was about the Big City Jacks update and that I was moving studios and moving myself in there. Well, I have done that and it's been just absolutely crazy. It's taken off way more than I thought it could. It's been super busy. So we've had a bunch of artists in recently, to name but a few. We've had Greenwire, Rosellas, we've had the Red Stains, we've had the Strangers, we've had Crude Virtue, we've had the Causeways, we've had the Notion, Redeemers, the list goes on and on. So thank you guys so much for coming to me to help you bring your dreams to life. Been having a whale of a time and it's not stopping there. We've got bookings for the next couple of months, which is cool. All that leads me to the next part, or the, shall I say, the point of this video. Hybrid working. Now, I have spoken about this before. There are certain pieces of gear that I like to use outside the box. I do work a lot in the box. I've got a lot of plugins, etc. This is the modern way, right? But there are a couple of pieces that I do like to have on outboard. Jesus, it's been a while. You'll have to forgive me. Anyway, recently I have acquired a pair of distressors nonetheless. And I've wanted a pair of distressors for like the longest time. And I finally got some. Now, why would I get hardware distressors? Well, the main reason is pretty much on the same lines as the reason why I got the Bluey, and that's to track through it. Because if it can get it right at the source, the closer you can get the source sounding to the finished goal, or the finished intention, then the easier the song is to mix. And so the whole process goes a lot easier. And so I've made myself a little rack of power, and in said rack of power, I'll show you in some B-roll, is the Bluey and both of the distressors. So that allows me to, for instance, compress kick snare room, or I can have stereo rooms, or I can have vocals. So we can do the Bluey into opto mode on one of the distressors. It does the opto mode thing really well, and that sounds amazing. When it comes to mix stage, I often use a distressor on the drum bus, and do the real distressors sound any different? Well, yes they do. Let me show you. Okay, so in Pro Tools we have currently the distressor, and this is the plugin variant. So these are the settings generally that I have. I have it on opto mode. But instead of having it on 10:1 opto, I'll have it on 20:1. And this is what that sounds like. Okay, and bypassed. And in. So as you can hear, it's adding a little bit of level and it's just generally thickening the drum sound. So let's bypass that plugin and let's bring in the real distressors. There we go. I hope you can hear the difference. I'm not going to do a full huge comparison because you can search YouTube for this and find this a million different ways. There's so many people that have done these comparison videos, you don't need me to do another one. I was just kind of giving you a quick example. Listen on headphones or monitors if you can and you'll really hear the difference. In a nutshell, what I'm hearing here is I'm hearing again, the same thing that I've said about the bus compressor in the past and the Bluey, there's just more 3D depth, there's more, I want to say aggression, but not quite. The plug-in sounds, the plug-in has the character of the Distressor, but it's a bit flat, and it kind of does a thing, but not the same thing that this does. This does a thing better, so, you know. Are they worth the thousands of pounds that they retail at? Sure. I mean, if you're in a position where I am, where you're taking them to the studio as well as being able to use them at home, and you're going to get a lot of mileage out of them, then definitely worth it, because you can use them on bass, acoustics, vocals, drums, pianos, percussion, you know, tambourine, shakers, all that kind of thing. They're a really, really versatile compressor. And again, I'm not going to go into huge amounts of detail about this because there are a million Distressor videos about what they do. If you're even watching this video and you've got this far, you already know what a Distressor is. This is my take on why I've got them. And I just really wanted to give you a little bit of an update and just make a video and put something out there, because it's been a long time and I've fallen off the bandwagon with YouTube. And I'm trying my hardest to get back on it. There are a lot of changes happening in my life at the moment. But more to come on that later. For now, if you're one of the thousands of people who watch my videos and don't subscribe, then don't be a jerk and subscribe. Hit the like button. Thank you for coming back again. Sorry if this was boring. I'm doing the best I can. See you next time. Don't be a dick. Goodbye.